First guest is a real estate artist and a five-time best-selling author. Three new books just released. Are you kidding us? On the same day?
Three books, three genres, all on the same day.
Woo, yeah. Baby.
Frank McKinney himself right here, just from Delray Beach. You have been on Oprah. You've been on a number of network interviews and shows. And, man, you have a story. We are so excited that you're joining us here on The Morning Blend.
Now my resume is complete.
What?
I'm on The Morning Blend here.
Frank,
come on.
Get here.
I closed the loop.
Got lost getting you over here.
Oh, no, we are excited. Come on. Yeah, I've had this on my bucket list, and now I can check it out.
Okay, and now you can go on to the great beyond with all that. So you're a real estate artist and an architecture artist and all of that. What ticks inside that noggin of yours?
Well, you know, I create some of the most magnificent homes in the world for the most wealthy people in the world. I build them on speculation, meaning I build them without a buyer in mind, like the Field of Dreams. Build it, and we hope they will come. I don't have a buyer when we start. We build them. This house we just finished, a $23 million house, fully furnished, down to the gold-plated toothbrush
in the
bathroom.
We're looking at this mighty majesty. What's her name?
That's Aqualiana. Fully furnished, linens on the beds, towels in the closet. So somebody walks in the front door, you're seeing the front gate right there, they can be sleeping there tonight if the check clears.
Bill, food. You can drive over there, right?
Food in the fridge?
Why food in the fridge.
Oceanfront property?
Yeah, that's the master bedroom right on the ocean.
Double his and her chandeliers.
Look at that.
Look at that. Can you see Carly walking down that every morning?
I can.
Good morning, Brooks. I'm ready for my coffee now. Now,
look at the aquarium.
Wait a minute. Now, how do you feed those fish in that fish
There's
tank?
An auto feeder there. That's actually an aquarium wet bar where it's a two-sided bar where the fish swim from the wine cellar all the way over the top. You can see there's an arch there. And they drop down into the bar top where you sit down your martini. You can sit with your best friends and look at the ocean and enjoy over 100 tropical saltwater fish.
And this is done. It's completely ready
just
to go.
Finished
Any
it.
Offers yet?
Yes, we've had some offers.
Okay.
We're trying to squeeze the difference between offer and ask.
Yeah, yeah. Names or,
I can't tell you that.
Oh, come on, Frank. You can tell. This between us.
I can't tell you that. Confidentiality agreements we have to sign if I violate it.
You heard your mouth to Oprah. You can tell us.
No, it wasn't Oprah. If it was Oprah, I would tell you.
Okay, all right. Anyway, well, we did the best we can. This guy is also a great writer.
Mm-hmm.
And there she is. Speak of the devil. And what are you doing here, Frank?
I have a go-kart track in my backyard. That's my go-kart.
Now, you don't live in necessarily a big, splashy, opulent.
No,
you don't live there, do you?
No, I don't live in any of the houses we built. Matter of fact, if you didn't like what I did for a living, you would say that I live in the antidote. I live in a house that was built in 1935. It's a very small house, but it's on the ocean. It's just the way my family and I like to live.
Well, you know what I think is great about you? You've done, we could talk all day about what the things that you have done, the success that you have had. And it all started, though. You have an interesting story. You grew up in Indiana, is that right? And then moved to Florida. First of all, what made you want to move to Florida?
Listen, I'm just a corn-fed country boy from Indiana. And I had a chance to kind of start to pursue my professional highest calling outside of Indiana.
Yeah.
So I went to four high schools in 4 years. It wasn't because my father was in the military. I was asked to leave one after the next. And I finally said, you know what? I got to get out of Indiana.
And
I got to start over.
GPA in high school. Well,
let's not share that.
That's
pretty embarrassing.
He was not a stellar student.
No, I didn't do too well.
But now you're a star.
Well, you know, what we do for a living, if you looked on the wall and you saw a Van Gogh or a Renoir or a Monet, wouldn't you love to jump inside that
painting? Heck yeah.
I provide that. I provide three-dimensional art that people can live in. They get a financial return, an emotional return from enjoying the artistry that we create. It just happens to be expensive.
How did you figure that out? How did you figure out how to do it so well?
What your lead talked about, Burst This, Frank McKinney's Bulletproof Real Estate Strategies, you got to read the book. Because in that book, takes the reader from that first $50,000 fixer-upper that I did back in 1986. I've been at this almost 25 years. All the way up to the most expensive greenhouse in the world.
There's the book right there. How many books have you written?
Five.
Five. Mm-hmm. And the most successful is your kid's book, which is something about lunchboxes and Dead Fred.
There it is right there.
Oh,
yeah.
Dead Fred, Flying Lunchboxes, and the Good Luck Circle. It happens to be outselling my real estate book. Now, it's a deep fantasy novel based in South Florida where I've walked my daughter to school every single school day of her life. It's over 1,200 walks to school. Laura, yes.
Give her a shout-out because she'll be watching it. Hi,
honey,
Laura.
Yes, we'll take this for you, and I wish I could have brought you today. But that's every work in fiction is rooted in some form of reality, and walking her to school every single school day of her life is where Dead Fred, Flying Lunchboxes, and the Good Luck Circle was born.
Now, you also did a marathon as well, and did the Death Valley... in South Florida. I'm not a runner, and I'm amazed at what you can do. So
Well, it's called the Badwater Ultramarathon. It's a 135-mile nonstop foot race across the
desert. There you go.
Across the Death Valley Desert in July, where the daytime temperatures average 130 degrees and the pavement temperatures are over 200 degrees. So if I don't wear the right shoes, they will melt. They will melt right on the.
Are you there, big guy?
I'm a 12.
Okay, me too.
Like, those are kind of beasts.
Walking his shoes.
Those are not my running shoes.
Yeah, those are nice.
But it's the world's toughest foot race, according to the National Geographic.
It's pretty good.
Non-stop, 135 miles. So that's I do it for the benefit of our charity, our Caring House Project Foundation. Yes.
Yeah. All right. Well, can you come back at the end of the show and we'll chat a little bit
more? We need to talk about the charity, what we're doing over in Haiti.
Yeah, what he's doing in Haiti. You know, reading your books is like walking a few steps in your shoes. Mm-hmm. And I do have on the odor eater, so I hope it won't be.
You feel that?
It feels good.
You feel good?
It feels comfortable.
I have a shoe.
Yeah, I like that.
I'll take yours home. Yours look a little newer than mine.
All right. Well, fires, hurricanes, and ambulances sounds like an emergency, right? Well, how your family can get some life-saving advice and have fun at the same time.